Oh, damn it, guys. I couldn't jump over there. He said OMG. That's what I'm saying, bro. Look at this. He says bow. Oh, he says to Lord Vex. All right, all is forgiven. All hail Vex. Bow down, everybody. Bow down.
Been a little too nice to y'all. Now I gotta up price for y'all. Snake eyes on dice for y'all. Shoulders on ice for y'all.
Frozen.
Before we dive into the video, guys, if you're new around here, please be sure to subscribe. And don't forget to turn on those notifications so you're notified of all my uploads. But most importantly, guys, don't forget to support the video itself by dropping a like if you happen to enjoy it. If you didn't drop a like on the video, you're gonna fail your next test. You don't want that to happen. I'm good luck for you. Drop a like on the video right now. No longer are we trying to become ninja legends. We're now trying to become a lumberjack legend, baby. In this game, we chop trees to earn wooden coins. We upgrade our gear, such as tools, backpacking, ranks. We can buy a motor.
2,000 years later.
It's a total package. Oh! Okay. Oh, dude, I kind of like this song. It's very upbeat. Oh, man. Don't you guys smell the sunshines and butterfly? Bro, look at a deer. What the? Anyway, we chop trees. Collect wood by chopping down trees. Now we can also upgrade our backpack. We can reach new areas. There's portals. We can use a GPS. And there's also apparently blueprints for buildings, which is kind of cool. Here's the pets. Then we can rank up. There's a VIP zone. Oh, yeah, baby. Look at our head, dude. Look at the size of my head. Hey, man. Come closer. Hi, bro. Yo, look at us, dude. All right, boys. So something really, really cool that I wanted to show you guys is that since your boys' clout levels have been increasing, some game creators are actually reaching out to me and giving me codes for their games. And this is one of the ones that I wanted to start off with. So they literally reached out to me and said, here's a promo code for your followers that will give you 25K coins. So you guys can use oGVexx with two E's and one X. I don't know why they did that. And that'll give you 25K coins. So just to show you guys, we're going to enter the promo code here. We're going to click unlock. And there you go. You get 25K coins there. Now, since I'm the best, I get a call with
Damn,
1 billion
son.
Coins. Get on my level. So we have a bunch of coins now, and I don't know how we're gonna go ahead and actually do this thing. So let's check out the different stores. We got one where we can upgrade. Oh, damn, dude, they have a lot of freaking things here to upgrade. So for this shop here for upgrades, we need whatever this fire currency is. So we don't have that. We don't have any of that fire currency, actually. I don't know how to get that, but yeah, this entire, like, dude, literally everything there or everything here on these stores requires that freaking fire currency, which I don't have. Oh, wait a minute. You know what, guys? I think there's just a mismatch. I think I do have all that fire. Yeah. Wow. Okay. We have a freaking golden jigsaw now. Look at this, dude. And our backpack is full. All right. So, yeah, there's just a mismatch between, like, I guess the emblem and the coins. I mean, the coins, if you look closely, kind of has that fire emblem. But it's just when you go to buy something, it doesn't really look like it that much, right? They should have used the same emblem for the coins and the currency to buy, whatever. Same thing. Now, I'm going to go ahead and try to rank. Oh, are you sure to want to rank up? You will lose your coins. Okay. Yikes. Let's take a guess. I mean, why not, right, guys? Why not? I decided to rank up. Now, I'm going to go ahead and keep on selling over here because apparently I can buy a blueprint if you look over here in the top left. And the first one is a wooden box. I want to see what that blueprint does for the wooden box. Now, this is also really interesting. While I'm doing this, pay attention to the fact that in the bottom left-hand corner, there is a friend tab that apparently gives you a bonus multiplier to things in the game if you invite more friends to the game. Now, a lot of the lobby is obviously just followers for me right now. Like, look at these guys. They literally just started playing, man. So now we can buy our first blueprint, guys. We're gonna buy the box one. And I honestly don't know what that did. I'm taking a little bit of a break, guys. I'm eating a cookie right now. All right, now that I'm done eating my cookie, apparently you can buy and build blueprints to actually get over difficult objects or obstacles, excuse me. So I think, oh, wait, I forgot that I can destroy trees. Dude, what am I doing? I'm such a noob, man. Look, so destroying the trees should be a little bit faster. Let me see if I can buy the infinite backpack. Yeah, you know what? I'll buy the infinite backpack one because this game looks pretty cool. And we'll just keep on chopping away. So apparently, you know, this should be a little bit faster if you chop down the trees to get some more wood than just swinging your axe in the air, you know? But yeah, I just wanted to point out that it seems as though you can go to new areas and, you know, you can pay, like, for example, 1K coins to go into the fire law or well, oh yeah, it is the Fireville Lava Docks. So we're going to do that. And then we also have a daily reward available. So let's collect this and see what we get. What the hell? Oh, we got a pet! Oh, dude, he just follows me around! Oh, that's adorable! Look at it! Oh, look, it has a little Santa hat and everything. So if I click the pets tab in the top right corner here, we can see all the different pets that we get. The Rudolph pets gives us plus 25% for the wood and the coins, right? The fire coins, I guess. Now, additionally, it seems that we can get, like, mounts in the game, which is new to me. I haven't played a Roblox game that had mounts, so I don't have that just yet. Oh, bro, look, you can sit on the bench, too. Oh my god, yo, my character just looks so funny with our small head, and then we have like our hatchet just like sticking out our axe. Oh god, dude, there are so many of you guys over here. Look at you, you're just destroying the freaking trees, dude. Oh, wait a minute, was that a VIP zone? Uh-oh, my inner pay-to-win senses are tingling, guys. So in the VIP zone, you get a bonus multiplier every day, times 10 coins, and you get an exclusive blueprint, high-tier bonus trees, and rank up much faster. It's $8 to go into the VIP zone. All right, you know what, guys? I'm actually going to do it. I looked through the store. They don't really have... Let me click buy now. But yeah, they don't really have, like, many, like, pay-to-win, like, passes, I guess you can say. I mean, some of them are kind of expensive, to be honest, but I'm probably just going to leave it at VIP. I don't think I'll buy anything else. It'll depend whether or not if I continue playing the game on the channel, if you guys happen to enjoy the game as well. So we're just gonna keep chopping, but it seems that this tree is giving us the same amount of a VIP reward. Here we go. We got boost coins 10. Oh, and if you look at the top left hand corner, it tells us that the times 10 coin boost only lasts 5 minutes. And what is this? We got a blueprint for a boat. All right. Yeah, I'm just gonna reassure myself and, you know, keep telling myself that VIP was worth it. Yo, some of these guys are saying oGVexx. Yeah, how does it feel, guys, huh? There's a difference. Ooh, dude, some of these trees are freaking golden. What does that mean? Oh, dude, what? I think when golden trees spawn, if they spawn, you get like a bunch more of wood out of it. All right, so let's sell all of our logs. We got some coins now. We're gonna go ahead and buy just a better axe. And now we have like the jade handsaw. So guys, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna unlock the Fireville lava docks because we have enough coins to do that. Look at this, the floor is lava pretty much, right? Oh man, you guys remember that little trend where everything was like, oh, the floor is lava, and it was like a bunch of different mini games and just like clickbait YouTube videos and whatnot. It kind of died out pretty quickly, but yeah, this is pretty much that, dude. So we reach a checkpoint. I think that they are timing us for this, so I don't know what will happen once we get through this in enough time, if we do. But homie over here is taking all my coins. That's all I know for sure, bro. Okay, we reached another checkpoint here. There's a portal to Fireville. What is this? Oh, damn, dude. What the? I just went back to the freaking beginning again. So I'm on my way back, guys. I'm almost pretty much done with this in a way. I'm kind of glad to see that this game isn't like Ninja Legends in the sense of like, oh, it's a bunch of different floating islands. So I'm kind of tired of seeing that like in simulator games, even though I've recently started playing Roblox and I haven't played that many simulator games. In the ones that I've played, I'm just like tired of seeing it. I just wish to see new things. So I'm glad that this game actually has like a platformer type of feel to it. So it's not really a copy and paste. And you know, I just did compliment this game, but already I'm going to say, bro, like ranking up is going to be, really? Oh, wait, I got a checkpoint. All right, so I don't spawn. Dude. But yeah, thankfully I spawned right over here. Dude, are you serious? Again? Nah, come on, bro. Not this time. There we go, baby. Nice save, Vex. So like I was saying, I did compliment the game, but I know that when you prestige or rank up or rebirth, whatever you want to call it, it's going to be a pain in the butt because honestly, dude, it's taking so long to reach the next island. Okay, now it's nighttime and I think we finally made it. Yeah, there we go. We finally made it to the Frozen Valley of Fireville. Or maybe not. Actually, we need to unlock the Frozen Valley of Fireville, but this is the frozen area, I guess. Oh, and finally, here we go. We have mounts. Do they have bikes? All right, let me go ahead and buy. I want to say, let me see. Well, honestly, we can only afford the yellow bike because every other color variant is just super expensive. So let's buy the yellow bike. Now, if we go into mounts, we can go ahead and mount. And we can... Bro, what the hell, dude? Look at this. Physics 101, baby. Oh, 10 out of 10, bro. Look at that, guys. You see the suspension, the coiling. Oh, man. Look at that, bro. Nice. I just love how we're not even freaking using the handlebars on the bike, bro. What the hell? Oh, dude. And you can swing while you're on the bike. All right. You know what, bro? I'm going to go back to the beginning area. I'm going to show off to these plebs. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, damn it, guys. I couldn't jump over there. Dude, look. He said OMG. That's what I'm saying, bro. Look at this. He says bow. Oh, he says to Lord Vex. All right, all is forgiven. All hail Vex. Bow down, everybody. Bow down. What I want to know right now, though, is if I get more wood out of attacking these trees. Oh, it seems like we do get more wood out of attacking the trees in the frozen area. Matter of fact, I actually have a lot. My guy, bro, it doesn't even look on screen. It says we're getting 125 wood every time we chop, but no, look at the bottom left hand corner. We're getting like 100k wood every time we chop down one of these trees. Look at that, guys. So I just went and bought a times 10 coins multiplier for 15 minutes, and we got 16 million coins on the auto sell. Well, on when we sell or sold, excuse me. So we're gonna go ahead and unlock this new area because we can. I'm pretty sure we could over here. Yeah, so we're gonna try to get to the next island in the game, and unfortunately, I have to buy blueprints. Yeah, I'm gonna have to buy a lot of blueprints. Okay, guys, I got some boxes. So here's how you do it. You pretty much just place the box and then you can... Oh, God. Maybe I should get off of my bike. All right, but yeah, once you buy a box, you can literally just do that. Get on top of the box and just use the blueprints that you get to traverse, like, the islands. And again, you guys let me know in the comment section below if there's other games that have used this in the past. But as far as I'm aware from the very few that I've played, this is completely new. I haven't played a simulator game yet that allowed me to, like, craft certain items to use those items to traverse, like, new subsequent islands. Well, guys... pretty much done here. This one looks really nice. I kind of like this. Oh, well, never mind. I kind of take it back. It's like foggy. You guys know me. If you watch my videos, you would know. Oh, dude, we get almost 600k logs every time we chop down one of these trees here. But yeah, I love like luscious greens and areas that have like a lot of trees and stuff like that. But this area is just like really, really misty and foggy. But getting that new rank should not take that long over here due to the fact that we're just getting an absurd amount of logs every time we chop down trees. Okay, so we have 5.3 million logs. Let's see how much that... Oh, dude, almost freaking 75 million coins. That's how much that auto sold for. I mean, sold. I don't know why I keep saying auto sell. And there we go. We sold again and we have 160 million coins. So I should be able to go into the shop here, go into ranks. And yeah, we definitely have enough to become a fire soldier now. So we're going to go ahead and buy that. And boom, baby. Oh, my boy has the merch. Look at him. Hey, brethren. What's up, brethren? Yeah. Woo.
For the record.